Quiet Nibs. This is ASMR. Aaron, thanks for checking out my channel. If ASMR, goddamn it, it's way too fast, dude. There we go. ASMR. Aaron, thanks for checking out my channel. If ASMR helps you with your anxiety, insomnia, depression, ADD, ADHD, PTSD, dyslexia, and more, like it does for me, then I hope this video is exactly what you're looking for. If so, don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment on what I should read next, since I upload a new video every day. Part 2 will be uploaded soon, or the full version is already uploaded on ASMRflix.com, depending on when you are watching this. Also, don't forget, if you're using this video to fall asleep, go to ASMRflix.com/fadeout. Copy and paste this URL, put it there, and you can tell it when to fade out as you fall asleep. You can put it for 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 15 minutes, whatever. Even 2 hours, if I'm not crazy reading that long. But today, we are reading the Bible in English, and I can't wait. Called Genesis. 1:1. In the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth. 1:2. And the earth was without form and void, and darkness was upon the face of the deep, and the Spirit of God moved upon the face of the waters. Thank you. lesser light to rule the night. He made the stars also. 1:17. And God said, them in ferment of the heavens to give light upon the earth. 1:18. And to rule over the day and over the night and divide the light from the darkness. And God saw that it was good. 1:19. And the evening and the morning were the fourth day. 1:20. And God said, let the waters bring forth abundant moving creatures that have life, and fowl that may fly above the earth, or in open the firmament of the heaven. 1:21. And God created whales and every living creature that moveth, which forth the waters brought forth abundantly after their kind, and were winged fowl after his kind. And God saw that it was good. 1:22. And God blessed them, saying, be fruitful and multiply, and fill the waters and the sea, let fowl multiply in the earth. 1:23. In the evening, in the morning, in the fifth day. 1:24. And God said, let the earth bring forth the living creature after his kind, cattle, of the earth after his kind, and then it was so. 1:25. God made the beasts of the earth after his kind, and the cattle after their kind, everything that creepeth upon the earth after his kind. And God saw that it was good. 1:26. And God said, let us make man in our image, after our likeness, and let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the fowl of the air, and over the cattle, and over all the earth, and over every creeping thing that creepeth upon the earth. 1:21. So God created man in his image, in his own image, and in the image of God created he him. Male and female created he them. 1:28. And God blessed them, and God said unto them, be fruitful, multiply, and replenish the earth, and subdue it, and have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the fowl of the air, and over every living thing that moveth upon the earth. 1:29. And God said, behold, I have given you every herb bearing seed which is upon the face of all earth, and every tree, and in which the fruit of tree yielding seed, to you it shall be for meat. 1:30. And to every beast of the earth, and to every fowl of the air, and to everything that creepeth upon the earth, wherein there is life, I have given every creature saw everything that he had made, and behold, it was very good. And the evening and the morning were the sixth day. The seventh day and sanctified it, because that in it he had rested from all his work which God created and made. 2:4 These are the generations of the heavens and of the earth when they were created in the day in the earth, and every herb of the field before it grew, for the Lord God had not caused it to rain upon the earth, and there was not a man to till the ground. 2:6 But there were men, there went up a mist from the earth, and watered of the ground. 2:7 And the Lord God formed man of the dust of the ground, and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life, and man became a living soul. 2:8 And the Lord God planted a garden eastward in Eden, and there he put the man whom he had formed. 2:9 And out of the ground made the Lord God to grow every tree that is pleasant to the sight and good for food, the tree of life also in the midst of garden, and the tree of knowledge of good and evil. 2:10 And a river went up of Eden to water the garden, and form thence it was parted and became into four heads. 2:11 The name of the first same as it that is compassing the whole land of Ethiopia. 2:14 And the name of the third river is Idkia, which is it which goeth towards the east of Assyria, and the fourth river is Euphrates. 2:15 Garden of Eden to try. press it and to keep it to 16. And the Lord God commanded the man, saying, of every tree of the garden thou must freely eat. 2:17. But of the tree of knowledge of good and evil thou shalt not of eat. For in the day that thou eatest thereof thou shalt surely die. 2:18. And the Lord God said, it is not good that man should be alone. I will make him an helpmeet for him. 2:19. And out of the ground the Lord God formed every beast of the field and every fowl of the earth, and brought them into Adam to see what he would call them. And whatsoever Adam called every living creature, that was named thereof. 2:20. And Adam gave names to all cattle, and to the fowl of the air, and to every beast of the field. But for Adam there was not found on help meet for him. 2:21. And the Lord God caused a deep sleep to fall upon Adam, and he slept. Inside thereof. 2:22. In the rib which the Lord had taken from the man made he a woman and brought her unto the man. 2:23. And Adam said, there is now bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman, because she was taken out of man. 2:24. Therefore shall a man leave his father and his mother, and shall cleave unto his wife, and they shall be one flesh. 2:25. And they were both naked, and the man and his wife, and were not ashamed. 3:1. Now the serpent was more subtle than any beast of the field which the Lord God had made. And he said unto the woman, yea, shall not eat of every tree of the garden. 3:2. And the woman said unto the serpent, we may eat of the fruit of the trees of the garden. 3:3. But of the fruit of the tree which is in the midst of the garden, God hath said, shall not eat of it, neither shall ye touch it, lest ye die. 3:4. And the serpent said unto the woman, ye shall not surely die. 3:5. For God doth know that in the day ye eat thereof, then your eyes shall be opened, ye shall be as gods, knowing good and evil. 3:6. And when the woman saw that the tree was good for food, and that it was pleasant to voice of the Lord God walking in the garden in the cool of the day. And Adam and his wife hid themselves from the presence of the Lord God amongst the trees of the garden. 3:9 And the Lord called God unto Adam, and said unto him, Where art thou? 3:10 And he said, in the garden, and I was afraid because I was naked, and I hid myself. 3:11 And he said, Who told thee thou wast naked? Hast thou eaten of the tree whereof I commanded thee that thou shouldest not eat? 3:12 And the man said, The woman who thou gavest to be with me, she gave me of the tree, and I did eat. 3:13 And the Lord God said unto the woman, What is this, what thou hast done? Said, The serpent beguiled me, and I did eat. 3:14 And the Lord God said to the serpent, Because thou hast done this, thou art cursed above all cattle and above all beasts. Shalt thou go, and dust shalt thou eat all the day of thy life. 3:15 And I will put enmity between thee and the woman, and between thy seed and her seed. It shall bruise thy head, and thou shalt bruise his heel. 3:16 Unto the woman he said, I will greatly multiply thy sorrow in thy conception. In the sorrow shall bring forth children, and they desire shall be to thy husband, and he shall rule over thee. 3:17 And unto Adam said, Because thou hast hearkened unto the voice of thy wife, he has eaten of the tree of which I commanded thee, saying, Thou shalt not eat of it. Cursed is the ground of thy sake, in sorrow shalt thou eat of it all the days of thy life. 3:18 Thorns also and thistles shall it bring forth to thee, and thou shalt eat the herb of the field. 3:19 And the sweet of thy face shalt thou eat bread till thou return unto the ground, for out of it wast thou taken, for dust thou art. Into dust shall thou return. 3:20 And Adam called his wife's name Eve, because she was the mother of all living. 3:21 Until Adam also and to his wife did the Lord God make coats of skins and clothes. 3:22 And the Lord God said, Behold, man has become as one of us, to know his hand and take also all of the tree of life and eat and live forever. 2:23. Therefore, the Lord God sent him forth from the Garden of Eden to till the ground from whence he was taken. 3:24. So he drove out the man and placed at the east of Garden of Eden cherubims and a flaming sword.